गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, ए हॉटी वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल डॉक्टर एम एच अन्नैया अकेडमी, माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर एम एच अन्नैया। फ्रेंड्स, इन टुडेज यूट्यूब वीडियो लेट अस लर्न हाउ टू लोकेट द सेंट्रॉइड ऑफ दिस लैमिना आर ए प्लेन फिगर विच हैज गॉट ए शेप एफ। सो हियर ऑल द डायमेंशंस आर गिवन एंड ऑल दिस आर इन मिलीमीटर। So this has got a maximum height of 100 and width is equal to 80 mm. So friends, here the given figure can be split into three rectangles. That is, I can just make a line here. This becomes one figure, this is the second figure, and this is the third figure. 1, 2, 3. So by drawing these lines, we can split this into figure 1, figure 2 and figure 3. And now, coming back to this centroid formula, we have this x bar given by x bar equal to a1 x1 plus a2 x2 plus a3 x3 divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3. So this a1, a2, a3 are the areas of these figures. So I will call this as figure number 1, the middle one figure number 2, and this small piece as figure number 3. So these are the three figures we have got, and we need to find out what is x bar for this. Friends, what is this a1, a2, a3? So before splitting the figure or locating the centroid, let us find out what are these a1, a2 and a3. A1 is the area of this figure, which is 80 into 20. A1 equal to 80 into 20, that is 1600 mm². Next, a2. A2 is the area of this figure. Is totally 100 minus 20 is 80. 80 into 20. So area 2 is again 80 into 20. That is 1600 square millimeter. Finally, area of this small rectangle is 30 into 20. So area 3 is equal to 30 into 20, which is 600 mm². So we have got the areas of all this figure 1, 2 and 3. Now I have to find out what is x1, what is x2 and what is x3. So x1, x2, x3 are the centroids, or the distance of the centroid of figure 1, figure 2 and figure 3 from the y axis. So let us see how to locate the centroids of these individual rectangles. So if we just join this diagonal, they meet at a point like this. This I call it as G1, the centroid of the first rectangle. And for the second figure, on the same line, if you just divide or join the diagonals, you get this G2. I can show it as G2 here. And for the third rectangle, G3, the point of intersection of the diagonals, so we'll call it as G3. So we got G1, G2, G3. Now, as per the formula, we need to find out x1. X1 is the distance of this G1 from y-axis. X2 is the distance of this figure from the y-axis. So let's write down one by one where this x1 required in the formula is the distance from y-axis till here. This totally 80 by 2, that is 40. X1 is 40 mm. X2 value is the distance of G2 from y-axis. This is just 10. Totally is 20 and half of that is 10. So X2 is equal to 10 mm. And finally, we need X3, that the distance from the y-axis till here. Friends, this is 15 and this is 20. 20 plus 15 is 35. X3 is equal to 35. And friends, if you add up all these areas, A1, A2 and A3, it works out to 3,800, 3,200. So 3,800 is the total area of the given surface of the lamina. Friends, now let us make the substitution of these values in the formula of X bar. So this works out to, so A1 is 1,600 into X1. X1 is 40 millimeter plus area 2 is again 1,600 into X2, that is 10. Finally, A3 is 600 multiplied by the value of X3 is 35 divided by A1 plus A2 plus A3, which I have added and got the value as 3,800. So 3,800. Friends, if you simplify this, the value works out to 26.57. The answer is 26.57 millimeter is the value of X bar. That is, from the Y axis, the G or the C of this figure lies at a distance of 26.57. Now friends, after calculating the value of X bar, let us find out what is Y bar by following the same procedure. So friends, for the Y bar, we have the formula given by Y bar is equal to A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 plus A3 Y3 divided by area, summation of the A1 plus A2 plus A3. So let us find out the value of this Y1, Y2, Y3 from the X axis. So friends, here Y1 stands for the distance of G1 from the X axis, from here to here. Totally it is 100 minus 10, that will give you 90. So Y1 is equal to 90 mm. That is from the X axis, bottom line, till here. So totally it is 100. If you subtract 10 from there, you will get as 90. Similarly, Y2 is the distance of this G2 from here. Friends, this is totally 100. This is 20. The remaining height is 80. 80 by 2. Means 40 millimeters is the value of Y2. Y3, friends, it is 40 up to here plus 10. That is the distance of G3 from the X axis is 40 plus 10, 50 mm. So after calculating the values of Y1, Y2, Y3, let us substitute in the formula and arrive at the value of Y bar. So this is given by A1 Y1, 1600 into Y1 is 90 plus area 2 is again 1600 multiplied by the value of Y2 is 40 mm plus area 3 is 600 multiplied by the Y3 value is 50. The whole thing divided by A1 plus A2 plus A3, if you add all these, it comes to 3,800. Friends, if you simplify this, the value of Y bar works out to 68.63. This is 68.63 millimeter. So friends, you can write down finally the centroid of this section is given by X bar comma Y bar, which is equal to 26.57 is X bar millimeter comma Y bar is 68.63 mm. So let us show practically where exactly the centroid lies for this figure. First of all, let us mark the value of X bar. It is 26.57. That is, from the Y axis, the X bar is at a distance of 26.57. So this is 20, maybe somewhere here you get a line. And I call this distance as 26.57, or x bar. 26.57 is this distance from the y axis. So from here to here, this is the value of x bar. Y bar is 68.68. Friends, from here to here it is 80. It will be lesser than that. It will come somewhere here. So this value, what I have shown here, is the value of y bar, which is equal to 68.63 millimeter. So this is the point of intersection of these two lines. Will give you G, the centroid of the complete F-shaped lamina. Friends, I thank you very much for watching my YouTube video. Have a wonderful day.